2013 Bollywood action thriller film starring Arjun Rampal, Shruti Hassan, Uma Qureshi, and the late Irfan Khan and late Rishi Kapoor in the lead roles. Why am I reviewing a 2013 film? It's because of the recent passing of Irfan Khan and Rishi Kapoor. Otherwise, I had no interest in this film at all. Ever since it started in 2013, it just flew right past me. I didn't watch it in theaters. I never watched it. This is my first time watching it. Also, there was a few little things which I found out, and this is another reason why I didn't want to watch it. This was released in 2013, and at that point in my life, I was watching only the big name stars movies. So, and even in Box Office India, the movie shown that it has flopped. It didn't do much business, so even then, that kind of put me in a downslide of not watching this movie even more. So that's another reason which I wanted to watch, didn't want to watch this, but I watched it now, and I kind of regretted not watching this in theaters at that day. Also, if you don't know, Shruti Hassan's movie, Ramaiya Vastavaiya, was released on the same day as this movie released. So she had two movies releasing on the same day. I don't know, that rarely happens though. So I felt like that was something which I could, you know, talk to you guys about. After their deaths, I kind of wanted a film where they both acted in the same movie, where they both worked together, you know? And after a bit of research, I found that D-Day was the only film they ever worked together. This is a really great movie. If you are a great fan of action and thriller, it's a really great movie to get behind. The performances are outstanding. There's a certain level of realism, and yes, this is a Bollywood film, so you will feel a little bit of that Bollywood-esque feeling in this movie. But it's not much, and sometimes it just flows right past you. However, the movie is not without problems, but I'll get to that later. Now, the reason I wanted to watch this movie is very, very simple. I just wanted to see Irfan Khan and Rishi Kapoor interact. I'm watching this movie mainly for them. I love Rishi Kapoor. He usually plays comic roles. I'm used to him playing comic roles, so this is my first time actually seeing him in a really serious movie. And wow, his character is based off of Dawood Ibrahim, and this is one of the best portrayals of Ibrahim that I've seen. I don't know if anybody can do it better, because he's that good. And Irfan Khan as Wali Khan, I love that performance, man. Just look at him, the amount of realism he brings to every single character. I'm really going to miss these actors. May their souls be in peace. They were the highlights of the movie by far, and I'm not just saying that because they recently passed away. This is my genuine opinion. They are the highlights of the movie. You can watch this movie just for them. Arjun Rampal plays your typical Salman Khan type of a hero here, because everything he does, it's usually this Salman Khan type of role, means the kind of roles he's presently doing, where he's this big, muscular, hulky guy who cares about nobody, but then eventually falls in love and then gets, you know. He's very Salman Khan in this movie. But he's the perfect casting, because otherwise a big name actor would have just stolen this movie and it would have just taken the flow out of it. Arjun Rampal was the perfect choice for this. Also, two other positives that I have is that the songs are really good. And I would really love to watch these songs as an album in YouTube. And if it's there, I would definitely be watching that, because the songs really stand out in this movie. It's one of the best I have seen. And I don't know if they're remakes or not, but from the movie standpoint, it's really good and it fits. I am going to give D-Day a 7 out of 10. It is a great movie. The thriller aspects are so on point, and the action, the choreography is so realistic. I never doubted anything for a minute. Although there are a few careless moments here and there, like during the song of Maskalandar, if you watch really closely, you can see the doorknobs changing in between scenes. There's small things like that, but unless you are, you know, going deep and analyzing each and every scene of a movie, you wouldn't really see it that much. There are a few problems that I have with the movie. It's not much. There's like only one or two. I did not understand this particular scene. If you know, please tell me in the comments below, because I would really like to know. Huma Qureshi's character, she breaks it off with her husband, and I don't understand why. Because from the scene, it looks like as though she cheated on him, but in the very next scene, it is shown that she actually killed him. So, I don't really understand that scene. If you do, please let me know in the comments. I would really like to know what that was about. And the only other problem I had was with the love story between Shruti Hassan and Arjun Rampal. It felt like you needed that, strong six-pack guy, the ex-soldier, the hardened, the hard stone-faced guy. You needed him to have a weakness or something, or you needed him for sacrifice. And so you just put him in this love story. Although it did feel natural when you look at it from the story point, but it just felt a little bit, off when I see it, because he shows up in one scene and then in the next scene they're in love. It threw me off a little bit. And the last and final thing I had was there are certain dialogues that was repeated, especially in the Huma Qureshi's character. She keeps saying, "Oh, we all sacrifice so much," dialogue so many times. It gets repetitive. I didn't like that repetitive dialogue. I wish they would have given her some other thing to say. Anything else would have been fine there. But instead, they chose her to say these repetitive dialogues. I understand why it's used. It's just that because it's getting repetitive, I just didn't like it that much. And that was my review of D-Day. Please let me know in the comments below what you thought of this movie. And if you like this video, please hit that like button, share this video with your friends, and hit that subscribe button. And hit that bell icon too, so that I keep coming onto your feed. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.